will return the favor.
You all right, Shrug?
It is that time of year again, and in the training camp of the Milwaukee Brewers, the boys and girls of spring are already at their positions, ever vigilant and skeptical, sizing up the newest superstar. Not that superstar, shortstop Robin Yount, this superstar, Yutaka Inatsu, the one with the interpreter in tow. For 18 years, Inatsu dominated the major leagues of Japan as few pitchers have ever dominated American baseball. After feuding with his manager, Inatsu stunned Japanese baseball fans by signing on for one final fling in the American major leagues.
I think it's my last chance of playing baseball. I feel I can still play ball. That's why I'm giving a challenge.
Here in Arizona, the former toast of Japan is merely another non-roster player. That is baseball talk for someone who must prove himself just to stay around. At 36, in the twilight of his career and several pounds overweight, Inatsu is fighting to become only the second Japanese import ever to make it in the American majors.
I just look at him as another veteran pitcher that's going to have to work hard to make a ball club.
He is fighting to become a relief pitcher on a staff that already includes Raleigh Fingers, one of the best in the business. At times, it is also a fight against loneliness, against a language barrier. Don Money, an American star who played in Japan, remembers that part well.
After a while, you're sitting in a corner in a clubhouse and you get tired of talking to your interpreter about it, and then ask him this or ask him that.
If I say no, if I say I'm not lonely, that'd be a lie. But I understood from before I came to here that I'll have that kind of problem. My only goal is to make it right now, and that's all I'm thinking.
Inatsu is not entirely alone here. It's club officials, it seems as though half the Japanese press corps came with him. Can Inatsu make it with the Brewers? Team leaders say it is too early to tell. But even on a team that finished last in 1984, hope springs eternal. Never mind the age factor.
Being 36 years old don't mean nothing. As long as you get somebody out, that's the only thing that counts in this game.
He won 200 games over there. He's doing something right.
And sweating beneath the Arizona sun, Inatsu is hoping, too, for a matchup with another aging superstar.
I was an individual, and I believe Reggie Jackson is also individualistic. And I feel like I like to challenge him and strike him out.
Inatsu versus Jackson. A dream, of course, but that's what spring is made of. Dreams and the old pros who dream them. David Dial, CBS News, Peoria, Arizona.
Maybe the dream will come true. Susan, have yourself a good night.
Thanks, Vic. Roads throughout southern Ontario are still clogged with snow tonight, and crews are out salting and sanding, trying to get them ready for tomorrow's rush hour. But we could have more in store yet. Bill Lawrence will tell us all about it when we return.
And the source of all this mess, the messy machine itself, an area of low pressure now moving through the Michigan Peninsula. Earlier today, the winds were out of the east, also associated with it, a southwesterly flow of warmer air. That's now moving across southern Ontario. In behind it, a westerly flow of cooler air. The leading edge of that cool air mass is now pushing in towards the Lower Lakes region. And as we go through this transitional period, it triggered the snow and the ice pellets. Now we're moving into an area of rain. And by the time this cold front goes through overnight, the precipitation should end. The winds become westerly and we start to cool off. Look at the satellite shot and you can see late this afternoon the positioning of that cold front. There it trails down from Michigan on down into Texas. That whole thing will clear our area overnight and tomorrow will be a better day than today. The forecast then, overnight, the mess becomes flurries, the winds out of the southwest. We come up from -6 to 0. And then for tomorrow, cloudy skies, winds out of the west, and we go down to -2. Nice sunny Wednesday in store, a high of -2 degrees. As for Thursday, here in southern Ontario, partly cloudy, a chance of rain again on Friday, and mild not far from 4 degrees. And that's a late night look at the weather.
And that's News Final for this Monday night. National Update is coming up next. With Vic Rauter, I'm Susan Harada. Good night.
Good night.